There are two blocks kept one over the other, and a force of 10 Newton is applied on it. The mass of block A is 2 kilogram and mass of block B is 8 kilogram. If the coefficient of friction between B and the floor is 0.5 and the coefficient of friction between A and the block B is 0.4, then what is the frictional force between A and B if a force of 10 Newton is acted on that? Let us try to understand this particular part. If the frictional force, you know that it is mu times the normal reaction. Frictional force, the maximum, which we call limiting friction. The frictional force between the B and the floor is mu times the total normal reaction. See, two A and B together weigh 10 kilograms and the downward force is 10 times the gravity, which is 100 Newton. So the normal reaction will also be equal to, the normal reaction is balancing this, then the normal reaction is 100 Newton. Then the force of friction between B and the floor, we call mu between the floor and B is 0.5 mu B into 100. So which is 0.5 into 100, which is 50 Newton. So the thing is, we have given only 10 Newton force on B. So this will not move the block B. Then obviously the system will not move. The friction will only oppose the relative motion. Let us see what happens with A and B. The weight of A on B is 2G, which is 2 times 10, which is 20. So we had done enough of it. So you know about how we calculate all this. So the weight of A, the downward force is 2 times G, which is 20 Newton. Then the normal reaction on A is 20 Newton. So it is 20 Newton means this is normal reaction on A. The total normal reaction on B is 100. Normal reaction on A is 20. So the force between A and B equal to coefficient of friction between A and B into the normal reaction. The normal reaction on A. So this is 0.4 into this normal reaction is 20. So 8 Newton. Not only for this particular problem we are going to solve this, we are going to understand the entire part. If you apply 10 Newton, the limiting frictional force between block B and the surface is 50 Newton. Hence, if you apply 10 Newton, then there will be a frictional force of 10 Newton will oppose this. If they ask you what is the force of friction between B and the floor, that is equal to 10 Newton now. If you apply 20 Newton, then the frictional force will be equal to 20 Newton. If you apply 40 Newton, frictional force will also be equal to 40 Newton. Only if you apply more than 50 Newton, the frictional force will not go beyond 50 Newton. Suppose if you apply 100 Newtons of force, then the frictional force between the block B and the surface is 50 Newton. From 50 Newton and above, if you apply the external force, then the force of friction between these two is 50 Newton. Now we have applied only 10 Newton. Then the frictional force between B and the floor is 10 Newton. Because this opposes this, the block B does not move. There is no relative motion between A and B. Hence, since there is no relative motion, the friction will only oppose the relative motion. Because there is no relative motion, there is no frictional force between A and B. Hence, frictional force between A and B here for this scenario of 10 Newton applied force is 0. The frictional force between B and the floor for the applied force of 10 Newton is 10 Newton.